Good morning, student. In our last video, we are discussing our sixth unit, physical activity and leadership training, in which we have discussed about leadership and the role quality of our leaders. Leadership, it is a social quality which is found in every other's people. Every other's people, various age, sex, members of the different community, cultures, different background people, etc. It is found in every other's people. Leaders means to lead a group. It is the ability. Leadership, it is the ability of an individual to influence other people, to motivate other people so that they cooperate with each other's toward the achievement of some common goal. And you know, without a good leaders, not any nation can move to a path of success. So leadership lead his group. Leadership lead his group, so give suggestions, guide his group, act as a model for others people, etc. And for a good leadership, without the cooperation of his followers, without the cooperation of his follower, the leaders cannot retain in his followers. For a good leadership, his follower should cooperate with a leaders. And there are two types of leaders: professional leaders and democratic leaders. Professional leaders means those leaders, professional leaders learn the quality of leadership by becoming a professional of that group. And democratic leaders, this type of leaders are chosen by the people. It is a choice of people. People make the leaders. And in democratic leaders, there are two types of leaders: mature leaders and immature leaders. Quality of leaders. The leaders should be academically sound. He should be well qualified, good commanding powers. He has full knowledge about his subject, needs of his group members. Good personality. A leader should have good personality. He should have attractive personality. He should be fit and healthy. His quality, his character should be good. He should have good moral characters. He should be an example for others. A leader should be intelligent and creative so that he create a new idea. Self-discipline. A leader should be self-disciplined. Regularity, punctuality, adjustment, politeness, and also inspire others to do the same. Determination. The leaders should have determination. Inculcate friendship. The leaders should encourage his group members to cooperate with each other, develop friendship with each other, develop team spirit, brotherhood, etc. Physical, master of physical skill. A good leaders should be able to demonstrate as well as explain the physical skill to the others. He should have the ability to demonstrate as well as explain whatever he is going to explain for a better understanding. Expressive and optimistic. The leaders should express his idea in an easy way. Loyal. The leaders should be loyal toward his group members and encourage his group to do the same. He should be an example for the others also. Leaders should be an example for others so that they can also be like him. Impartial. The leader should be impartial. He should be impartial and should justify to their group. So in short, we can say that The quality of leadership LEADERSHIP So the quality of leadership in which L means loyal. The leader should be loyal toward his group members. E means energetic. The leader should be energetic. He should have endurance, engaging personality so that he will engage his group members. A means the leader should be alert, adjustment ability, absence of functional defect. R means LEAD leadership. D means discipline. The leader should be disciplined, dutifulness, dependability, ability, desire to help others. E means energetic. The leader should be energetic, enthusiasm. S means the leader should be sincere, sympathy, attitude, self-control, social ability. He should have social quality. H means he should be helpful in nature. He should be healthy, fit and healthy. I means he should be impartial. He should be intelligent. Interest in helping, teaching others person. P means the leader should be patient. The leader should be patient, preservative, personality. He should have good personality, physical appearance, public relationship, etc. This is the quality of our leaders. Now, next is creating leaders through physical activity. How you create leaders through physical activity? The first point for creating a leaders is, first you have to appoint a leaders. Okay, first you have to appoint a leaders for different activity. Whatever the activity you want to make a leaders, first choose the leaders, appoint the leaders. For example, making the leaders of the team game, making leaders of the class, making leaders, making captain of the school, making house captain, etc. First point is appoint a leaders. After appointing a leaders, give him responsibility for conducting the program. We should give him independent responsibility for conducting the program, and the teachers should check for his mistake. Give authority. After giving responsibility for conducting the program, give him some authority so that he can take his own decision regarding the conduct of the program. Okay, give authority, give power so that he take his own decision, and if he make a mistake, do a check over and correct him if he make a mistake. Guidance to leaders. Teachers should guide, guiding force to the leaders, and give some technical tips to control the groups. Assigning duties. After that, assign our duties to our leaders, like equipment arrangement, discipline, control of the team, etc. Recognitions and honors. The leaders, we should give some recognitions and honors to our leaders so that it will motivate the leaders and perform their duty in a better way, like giving a badge, chess logo. Special consideration. We should give special considerations for their program. Whatever they had done, we should appreciate them in a public place. Technical tips. After the program is over, give some technical tips to the leaders for improving the leadership ability. Role of leaders. What is the role of leaders? First is group representation. A leader is represent his group. He expresses the idea, thought, and interest of the group. He takes all the decision on behalf of his group. Okay, leaders represent his group. He expresses the idea, thought, and interest of the group, and as well as he takes the decision on behalf of the group. Opportunity to direct. Leadership provide an opportunity to direct his group. It helps in creating a command. Leaders command his group, class, or team in a team for better control in a better way and excels in every spheres. Okay, leaders direct his group. For example, controlling his team, controlling the class, etc. Next is reduce stress. Leaders helps to reduce the stress of the teacher or coach. It enables the teacher or coach to spend more time for teaching or coaching or other impartial work. It reduces the stress because the leaders help the teacher. Therefore, leaders helps to reduce the stress of the teachers. Better discipline. Leaders helps to maintain better discipline in the school and in the playground. If he is a leaders of a game playground, then he will make a discipline in a playground. If he is a monitors of the class, then he will maintain the discipline in the class. So leaders helps to maintain discipline, and also as he assists the teachers or coaches to maintain a discipline. Develop socializations. A leader develops social quality among its team members and encourages others to do the same. Okay, the leader develops social quality. Develops social quality like discipline. He maintains the discipline. He maintains friendship attitude, adjustment attitude, cooperation attitude with his team members, and also encourages his team members to do the same. Inspire others. Leaders inspire his group. Student leaders encourage and inspire others to perform better. Leaders motivate him, motivate his group, inspire them to give their best performance. Close relationship. A leader has a close relationship with his team members, means with his student as well as coach. Therefore, there is a better understanding between them. Leaders has a good relationship between the coach as well as the student, because the leader is from the student. Therefore, he has a close relationship with the student, and he has a close relationship with the teacher also. Therefore, leaders act as a medium to convey the message from his group to the leaders, and from his group to the coach, and the coach message to his group. Better organizations. Leadership improve organization skill. Thus, better organization. There is a better organizations. Leaders ensure better adjustment and good use of resource. There is a less wastage of resource. Good medium to convey. Leader act as a good medium to convey between the student and the teachers. Therefore, there will be the better understanding between them. Improve ability. Good leadership improve various skill and ability of the leaders and group. Thus, progress for all. Leadership improve the ability of all leaders. Provide recognitions. Good leadership provides recognition of the group. If the leaders is group, then it improve his group. Good leadership provides recognition of the group in the society and impress everyone. Inspire, improve coordinations. Leaderships have to maintain a coordinations between his group. Thus, the collective effort of the group. There will be the collective effort between his group. Next topic is adventure sports. Adventure sports are the risky and dangerous activity which are mostly performed in the natural environment. Okay, and adventure sports, it is a very risky and dangerous activity in which we perform in a natural environment. This activity give us, adventure activity give us exciting and unusual experience with uncertain outcome. The outcome of adventure sports is uncertain. We don't know what will be its outcome. In adventure sports, the individual compete with the natural, with the nature rather than with the competing against the another individual. Okay, in adventure sports, we compete with the natural environment. These sports are not just for fun, but also there are number of benefit of adventure sports, like it's increase the confidence because the outcome is uncertain. Therefore, it develop confidence in a person's, it motivate courage to face the obstacles of the life, etc. Adventure sports are defined as the activities in which there is high degree of risk. Okay, in adventure sports, the degree of risk is high to the participant needs and to store mentals makeup. Therefore, the individuals have to be mentally makeup for the adventure sports. Thus, the adventure sports can be defined as physical activity in which the person is exposed to the adventurous activity give lot of excitement. First thing is, in adventure sports, we compete in the natural environment. We perform in the natural environment. We do competition with the natural environment. And the outcome of adventure sports is uncertain. Therefore, this adventure sports is very excitement, thrill, increase anxiety, develop self-esteem, develop confidence, etc. And there are various type of adventure sports like rock climbing, mountaineering, trekking, river rafting, paragliding, etc. These are the some adventure sports. These activities are also termed as extreme sports. Adventure sports is also known as extreme sports. These activities gained the popularity in 1960 onwards. Nowadays, these activities are very popular, especially among the youth and media, and has increased the tourism industry to a new height. Nowadays, various tourists participate in the adventure sports. It acts as a program. Adventure sports are different from traditional sports. These are activity usually compete in the natural environment, and it involve the risks, high risks and excitement. It is very dangerous activity. Therefore, the person should have full physical fitness. He should be mentally fit, physically fit, healthy. He should have good physical fitness, means he should have strength, speed, endurance, flexibility, coordinate ability, as well as he should have knowledge, technique, एक्सेट्रा। अकॉर्डिंग टू इकोनॉमिक सर्वे इन इंडिया, नाउ दिस एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट्स इज अपकमिंग बिजनेस एंड इट प्रोवाइड लॉट्स ऑफ जॉब एंड प्रोफेशंस। मोरओवर टूरिस्ट इंडस्ट्रीज हैज ग्रोन टू अ न्यू हाइट ड्यू टू दिस एक्टिविटीज। दिस इज अबाउट द एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट्स। नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट्स। फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव इज मिनिमाइज pollutions. Adventure sports helps to minimize the pollutions because in adventure sports we perform in the nature, we perform in the natural environment. Therefore, pollution is minimized and uplift the natural environment. Protections of wildlife. This activity create awareness among the people to conserve and protect the wildlife. If person do the activity in nature, in natural environment, they become aware about the wildlife. Therefore, it helps to protect our wildlife. Use of natural resource. Adventure activity create a sense of proper use of forest resource and to avoid deforestation, because when they come in the natural environment, they come in the nature, then only they understand about the natural resource, nature. They will understand about how to use the natural resource and avoid deforestation. Understanding the nature's adventure activity helps the persons to understand the nature, natural phenomena, and guide us to conserve the natural resource. Healthy activity. Adventure sports is a healthy activity. Today, youth is deflected towards the health hazard like drugs, alcohol. Therefore, the athletes should be motivated to perform in this adventure sports, as well as it is very healthy. Give excitement rather than unhealthy activity. Information about area. Adventure activity give us information about the area and its topography, leadership and togetherness. As adventures activity we perform in a group. Therefore, it helps to develop togetherness between the team members, and in group there will be the one leaders. Therefore, it also helps to develop leadership quality. Develop physical fitness. Adventure sports help to develop physical fitness among the people. It's help to deal with challenging situations effectively. Gives thrill and recreation. Adventure sports give thrill and recreation, mean feeling of excitement. In adventure sports, you will feel excitement. There will be the recreation and develop in you to take the risks. Make you risk taking. Overcome the problems and develop creativity. Adventurous activities gives an idea to overcome problems, because in adventure sports the outcome is uncertain. There may be any problems during the adventure sports. Therefore, you will get a knowledge, you will get an idea how to overcome the problems, and experience, you will get an experience to deal with emergency. If there is any emergency, if there is any problem, you get a knowledge how to overcome from that problems, and it also develop creativity in you. Organizational skill. Adventure skill give us idea to practice organizational skill, which are important in life. It also bring creativity. It's develop organizational skill. Encourage tourism. Adventure sports encourage tourism and give jobs and professional to many, because nowadays the tourists are encourage tourism, because adventure sports tourists wants to do the adventure sports. It encourage the tourists to participate in the adventure sports. Therefore, this adventure sports become a job, become a profession to many people. Considering safety means, in this activity, the safety tools and safety means are considered. We should use proper equipment, safety equipment to perform the knowledge about forest resource. Adventure activities helps us to understand and give us knowledge about forest resources, their use, how to use the forest in a proper way. We get a knowledge about it. These are the objective of adventure sports. So we have discussed about adventure sports and its objective. And in our next video, we will discuss about some adventure sports like rock climbing, mountaineering, trekking, camping, paragliding, river rafting, etc. Let's discuss once again adventure sports. Adventure sports. In adventure sports, we compete with the natural environment, and the outcome of adventure sports is uncertain, and it is very risky and dangerous activity. But adventure sports give you excitement, thrill, enjoyment, because you don't know the outcome. You compete with the natures, and the risk of adventure sports is very high. Therefore, you should be physically and mentally fit for the adventure sports. If you participate in adventure sports, it's help to develop confidence in you. It's help to overcome emergency, how to overcome with emergency, increase. Today, adventure sports is also becoming as a professional. It encourages tourists to participate in adventure sports. Therefore, adventure sports give jobs to many people. Objectives: the first is minimize the pollution, because we perform in the nature environment. Therefore, the pollution is less. Protection of wildlife: if we perform in natural environment, we get a knowledge about the wildlife. Therefore, it helps. It gives us knowledge to protect the wildlife. Use of natural resource: we get a knowledge about how to use the natural resource, and also it gives us to avoid deforestation. It's help to understand the nature, natural resource, give us, it guide us to conserve the natural resource. Healthy activity: adventure sports, it's a healthy activity, because we perform in the natural environment. Therefore, it is a healthy activity. Nowadays, today generation, people are taking drugs, alcohol, etc. Therefore, we should encourage the people to participate in the adventure sports, healthy activity. Information about area: we get a knowledge about the area. Adventure sports develop leadership quality, because it helps, because it gives you an opportunity to lead a group. Therefore, your leadership quality develop. As well as adventure sports, it perform in a group. Therefore, it will develop togetherness, develop friendship attitude between you, how to cooperate with each others. Develop physical fitness: if you perform in physical adventure sports, your physical fitness will also develop. It will develop your strength, endurance, speed, etc. Adventure sports give you excitement, recreationals, etc. It also teaches how to overcome the problems and develop creativity. In adventure sports, the outcome is uncertain. Therefore, if you perform in adventure sports, you will get an idea. You will get a new idea how to overcome the problems, how to deal with the emergency, etc. Organizational skill. Adventure sports develop organizational skill in you. Encourage tourists considering safety tools, and we get a knowledge about the forest. These are the objective of adventure sports.